This woman had been missing for 42 years when they finally closed the case. This man from upstate New York took his wife to the doctor, but discovered something unusual when it was time to fetch her. Several hours after he dropped her off, it was time to pick her up and go home. When he got to the doctor's office, his wife was nowhere to be seen. Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. He returned and waited for his wife to show up. She never did. Where was she and what happened? What could have happened to her in the first place? The case was closed only 42 years later. He brought her to the medical appointment of hers earlier that day. They didn't find anything unusual about her, only a bad head cold. He dropped off his wife and told her he'd be back in an hour or so. She was Florence Flora Stevens. Her husband last saw her on the 3rd of August, 1975. She'd been 36 years old at the time. She was full of life and adventure. So how did she vanish into thin air like that? During the summer of 1975, Flora Stevens worked at the Catskill Mountains. The resort was called the Concord. It was a 1,200-room resort that was very popular among the tourists living in the area. From her application, the detectives learned that she went to Lincoln High School in New York. While they did not have tons of information on her, they knew that her husband was Robert Stevens. No one had any idea where she could have gone. As soon as the investigation was opened, people started to look for this woman. Everyone was shocked by the disappearance. Where did this nice woman go? Sadly, clues started to arrive less and less. They didn't find living relatives of Florence, so it was almost impossible to figure out where she was born. It seemed like the end of the road for everyone back then. The case had to go cold because no one had any leads on what could have happened to her. No one had any clue that this disappearance case would be reopened about half a decade after this. In 2017, Jan Solomon found something that seemed to answer questions in a case he didn't know even existed in the first place. What did the senior investigator at the New York State Police find? As you might have guessed, it had something to do with Florence, Flora Stevens' case. Did he find her? Where was she? Was she safe? Many questions needed answering in this case. However, he didn't come bearing good news. He found a woman, that was true, but he only found skeletal remains. He needed help to identify who this person was. Could it be Flora Stevens? He needed to get his phone and make several calls. He called the Sullivan County Sheriff's Office and asked for a detective. He needed help to learn more about the body he found in the Catskills area. In the United States, about 70,000 adult women disappear every single year. It was going to be hard for him to solve this case without relying on help from other people. Luckily, he had a brilliant idea. As of January 2016, there had been 21,894 active missing women cases across the U.S. They kept records of cold cases in storage, which meant they could gain access to that data if needed. Solomon was aware that this would be hard, so he assembled a team to work on the open cases. They were tasked to look for similarities to the remains they found. This way, they could find this woman. Even though it was a long shot, he drove to Sullivan County to conduct his very own research. He wanted to make it easy by working on local searches. He was hopeful that it would help crack the case. He could tell that the woman came from this area. What he needed then was answers to the questions he had. He found an open case that appeared to match the description of the findings he had on hand. Could this be the answer that he'd been waiting for all this time? He asked the detectives to see if this woman had any living relatives. Much to his dismay, the records indicated that there never were any. The missing woman file was rather old. The case was opened in 1975 and did not provide Solomon a lot of information. However, something clicked for him anyway. What could it have been? Solomon diverted this case to the Sullivan County detectives. It went to the hands of Detective Rich Morgan, who was tasked to look up for a connection for this woman. He dug up something soon enough. It turns out they found a work ID, which revealed that this woman had been employed at the Catskills Mountains in the past. It was found in the same place as the remains of the other woman. A 36-year-old woman by the name of Flora Stevens disappeared back in 1975. Get ready, because we're about to tell you something mind-blowing about this case. It's surprising, we'll tell you that. Detective Morgan managed to solve the puzzle in front of him. As far as he was concerned, this cold case and corpse did seem to be connected. He launched an investigation into the location of Flora Stevens. When she went missing, her husband worked hard to look for her anywhere that seemed plausible. He just dropped his wife off at the doctor's and had no idea that it was the last time he'd ever see her. The investigation started from then on. It was sad that they didn't know a lot of new information about her. He died a decade after her disappearance. seemed like the case was simply full of dead ends. Detective Morgan was aware that it was not going to be fun and games since Flora Stevens had no living relatives. He didn't know what he could do to prove that the remains Jan Solomon found were hers. He went through the local and national databases. It was then that he found something crucial. It seems like there was someone out there using the social security number of Flora Stevens. Who is it? He tracked down the number to a place not far from Boston. He could not believe what he found. Someone had been using the social security number of a missing person in an assisted living home. He called the facility. They told him that the record did belong to an individual called Flora. They'd had her last name listed down as Harris, not Stevens. This woman had been there since 2001. Detective Morgan went to the facility with another investigator. The two of them were shocked by what they found there. As you can see, they clearly had no idea where this cold case was about to take them. Here was what Detective Morgan told CBS Boston when he talked to them. Same first name, different last name, the same birthday and social security. It was clear that they had to talk to this woman. They brought the sole photo of Flora they had in the database. It was a photo lifted from her work ID at the Catskills Mountains. They got to the establishment and introduced themselves to this woman. Her reaction floored them completely. She held the photo and pointed at the woman, Detective Morgan said. She says, "That's me," or "me," she responded with one word, "me." When they showed her a photo of her husband, they knew that she was the one they were looking for. After all, she said, "Robert." Sadly, the elderly woman could not answer any questions they had about her disappearance. Why? Well, Flora is suffering from dementia and could not remember anything about the past 42 years. Detective Morgan recounted, "We really don't know the circumstances of why or how she disappeared. She had psychiatric problems leading up to that point. Her caregiver, by the name of Mabuva, revealed what he knew of her previous life. Apparently, the older woman had a bad marriage and an abusive spouse. The detectives now believe that she got a bus ticket and left town to escape her terrible husband." Detective Morgan said, "Most of the secrets are locked inside Flora, and I don't think we'll ever get them." Festus Mabuva, her caretaker for over a decade, said, "To be honest, I don't think she ever really wanted to be found. You can tell something happened in her past that she didn't want any part of. Flora grew up in Yonkers and said none of your business often." Eric Chibodi, the Sullivan County Undersheriff, said, "It's a neat feeling to find someone. The main thing is we know that Flora's safe." At long last, they solved the mystery of the disappearance of Flora Stevens. During the press release, Sheriff Mike Schiff said, "It's not too often you get to solve a 42-year-old missing person case. It took 42 years, but they finally found out what happened to a woman who vanished into thin air. Sadly, we don't know all the answers." The 78-year-old woman only smiled and waved from her wheelchair. Thankfully, the authorities ended up finding Flora. But would preschool sweethearts Matt and Laura ever be reunited after so many years? Only time would tell. Don't forget to subscribe for more inspirational stories.